Today is a special video. Why? Because each one of these pieces, look
at this. Each one of these takes like 3 months, 4 months to create one of these. One of these, one of these, one of these. And there are hundreds. Like, just look here. Look at this. This is unique in the world. Unique. I'm at the workshop, L'Atelier de Jacobo and Maria Angeles, and this place is changes my mind. Why? Because it makes me think, damn, if it takes 5 years or 7 years to create some of these pieces, it's about caring, like creating something unique, and something unique cannot be created in 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks. It's not about getting rich quick. It's not about, yeah, just doing something quick because we already have the name, right? We are already popular and famous because of what we did, our 30 years of trajectory. This couple, I could talk today with Jacobo. He's over here. He's there at his workshop, like painting and designing. And Maria as well. Amazing. This woman, she was talking with me. We are talking about coherence, being, having integrity, you know, being all the message that you are putting out there in the world has to make sense. Like this, probably the person that is starting this, it's not going to be the same person that is going to finish it. And this is a concept that they were talking about, Tekkyo. What's Tekkyo? And it's something that resounded like, boom, wow, this is really extraordinary, right? It's from Extraordinary's community, our philosophy. Tekkyo talks about doing something for the well-being of all the community, but not for your own well-being, you know? It's an activity that you do for the community, for the collective well-being, for the collective benefit, you know? Tekkyo. Popular word here in Oaxaca, in Mexico. And as you can see here, look at this. Look at this. They are cutting it. Like, you can be like, copal wood. And they're full of them. Like, look here, they're painting them. And the thing is, what can we do when we feel already complete, when we already feel happy? What can we do to benefit the whole society? What can we do to benefit our community, our members, our students? You know, if you have an online business, they made me think, you know, because I was talking with Maria, and she said, I'm already doing well. It's like, yeah, I can tell. You have 200 people working in this project every single day, 200 people per day in all this big building that it's like a little town. It's like a little village, literally. Like, they have crops, they have the part that it's clay, the boot part, the paintings. Like, this is like a little town, 200 people here per day working, and then plus the visitors. And she said, I'm doing already well, right? But I asked myself, what's my purpose? Why did I came here? Why did I come here in this planet? To do what? And she said, this is my purpose. I just love doing this. And yeah, she said, I could live in a mansion. I could live in a bigger house and with more luxury, and I could wear like more luxurious and expensive clothes, but I don't need it. When we are making more money, I'm happy to reinvest it here in this project. We are planting 5,000 trees and I don't need it, you know? She said, and we are also saving in case our sales go down. We still need to pay these people that are here, you know? We want to pay what's fair. And, you know, coming to this place, project, successful project, after 30 years of starting it, founding it, it's truly amazing. Like, everything, it's made with so much love and so much detail, you know? This is extraordinary. This is unique. You cannot find this anywhere else in the world. And they've been around the world presenting this. But every message, you see, every message, every
everything, actually everything, it's made with touch, with taste. It's amazing. So I thought, what can I build that maybe takes 5 years, 10 years, but I'm gonna be proud, and it's gonna be something that cannot be replicated, you know, because somebody can replicate the model and copy your idea. Sometimes I remember like 6-7 years ago when I started with this entrepreneurship thing, I attended some workshops that said, hey, if I have an idea and somebody copies, it's like, then it's not something unique if anybody can copy it, because not everybody can copy this, you know, this uniqueness and attracting hundreds of people to want to participate and collaborate in this project is truly inspiring. And they are not in a rush, as I'm telling you, they are not in a rush. They just want to build something they find meaning, something they are proud of. Even if it takes 5 years to say, hey, let's create a bull. There's a bull up there with gold in this part here of the bull, and everything is with this little detail. And they are like, yeah, let's do a bull. It's gonna be in 5 years finished. Okay, let's go. And somebody starts a piece, like the head of the bull, the body of the bull, knowing that still 4.5 years left, 4 years left, 3 years left, and that they're gonna start and collaborate with some part, but probably the artist that is gonna start with something, it's not gonna finish it. This is creating something remarkable and unique and extraordinary. You know, it's not about themselves. They're like, look, the name is Jacobo and Maria Angeles, but this is not about us. We just started this, but the project, it's the project in itself. We just give the name as the founders of this. Wow, and I can feel it. You know, it's definitely something you can feel here. If you can come and have this energy, and you can meet them personally and you can talk to them, it's fantastic. It's fantastic. So my thought is, imagine you want something like financial independence, right? Financial independence in 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, who cares? If you get to that point, who cares? You know, make something remarkable. Shoot for something remarkable, what I call the moonshot. I learned this concept from OKR's book, John Doerr. Moonshots. Something that if it happens, if it's, it becomes real, it's gonna be like, wow, like big wow, like this. So this is my question for you. What would you do, even if it takes 10 years, that makes you feel excited, that it's fulfilling a purpose that you know you came to this life to do? What is it? And again, the truly remarkable, unique things in the world, take this time. You know, the thing is, are you willing to put this time? Are you willing to go in that direction? Be flexible on the details, but stubborn on the vision. If you are visionary, if you are a person that wants to change a little world, a little part of the world, of the society, whatever it is, even if it's a town from Mexico, from Oaxaca, like they did, but that then they expanded and inspired other artists in the world. Whatever it is that you want to do, achieve financial independence, geographical freedom, you know, time freedom, be time wealthy, whatever it is. My question for you is, are you just wanting the outcome, or the things you are doing every single day is fulfilling your passion and you are enjoying the journey? Miguel from Oaxaca, from Jacobo and Maria Angeles workshop, atelier, taller. See you in the next video.